what's going on, guys and gals? Hey, listen, this is a question that we get a lot, and we're going to go over it real fast. What they're basically wanting to do is add an FX to Mix Bus 1, coming from a vocal mic, input 1. And what happens is when they change the level of the fader at front of house, it also changes the level of the FX going into that monitor. Well, believe it or not, that's exactly what you want. But he wants to do this the opposite way, okay? So it's real simple to do. Let's go ahead and jump down into X32 edit, and we'll see what's going on. Okay, guys, here we are. I got a SM58 coming in on channel 1, and I've got a Mix Bus 1 set up for my inner monitors. So if we come up to the send now, if you want to put that pre-fader on this right here, if we send this signal to this Mix Bus and that FX, and we don't want it to change by this fader, then we've got to set this to pre-fader. It's just that simple. You have to, okay? So now if we come up here and we look, we got the vintage room right here on Mix Bus 13. We come back to sends. Channel 1 is highlighted, and we simply run it in there, and there's our FX. Okay, I'm going to pop this out here. I'm going to try and do a little bit of adjustment on this because I really want this to stand out and show you why you really want this on post fader instead of pre-fader, okay? So let's go back to the sends. Check two. Let's take the room size. There we go. You hear that ringing? Check two, three. So we're going to leave it here for now. It's going to be a little bit annoying. Okay, we're going to go sends on fader here by clicking mine. I'm going to bring this into this Mix Bus. Somewhere around Unity. I'm going to solo out this Mix Bus, and as you can tell, the FX has now instantly went away. And the reason for that is because we have not added it into my Mix Bus yet. So if we click on this and we come down to the aux FX, you can see there's our signal right there. I would have to add this in just like you see it coming in now. Okay, you hear that annoying little twang there at the end. Let me do something here real fast. Check two, three, four. There we go. So what I want to do now is show you what happens. Okay, now you got all this set. You got this sent to your in-ear monitors. And this is what they're listening to. They're listening to all of this reverb and stuff coming through. And this is the same way you're going to hear it at front of house. But now watch what happens when I drop this fader down. You're going to hear my vocal come out of this, but you're going to hear that FX stay up there at that same level. Now imagine if this was on instruments. Anything you have that FX right here set to on 13 for pre-fader, it all goes pre-fader. You can't choose pre-fader on one channel and post-fader on another. It doesn't work that way. Okay, so just watch what happens now. Check two, three, four. You hear my voice coming over the FX now.
Check two, three, four. You hear that reverb, hallelujah? But yet my vocals dropped out of it. Now let's
unsolo the bus. Now we're hearing it through the mains.
Okay. And this is what it would sound like coming through the mains now.
There's no difference in it. Okay. But yet, if you go back and you put this on post-fader, where it's supposed to go, and now when you drop this down, check 2-3. Let me come out of this, go back over here into the front of house part of it. Clear the solo, check 2-3-4. If you notice now, you can hear my voice, but that annoying twang is gone because the FX has now come down with my voice. And what I was saying right there is when I dropped this fader down, this is what you're hearing this video through. I'm using this to make this video. When you drop this down and that volume goes down, that FX comes right down with it. It's almost like when you put this post fader, it's actually turning this into a DCA. Because as you move this down, internally, it's moving this FX down with it. Again, you can do it on pre-fader. Right there it is. I just showed it to you. Okay? But if you do it like this,
and then you come up there and you're trying to do all these other instruments, and you got these effects on this,
it's really going to be aggravating for you during the show. Okay? I hope this helps. Take care. God bless. And we are out of here.